See, we are dealing with impact. I explained already what is direct impact, oblique impact, and also loss of kinetic energy due to direct impact. Three derivations. Then, some problems I have already solved. Consider some more examples. Three equal spheres are in a straight line on a table, and one moves towards the other, which are at rest and not in contact. If E is equal to half, find how many impact will take place. Show that the ultimate speeds of the spheres are in the ratio 13:15:36. See, the problem is like this. Three equal spheres, they are on a straight line on a table, they are equal, mass is same, and I take first, second and third sphere, first, second and third sphere, masses are same. Now, one moves towards the other which are at rest, first one moves towards the other which are at rest. Therefore, problem is, find how many collision or impact take place, and also, finally, ultimate speeds of the spheres are 13:15:36. First part is how many impact will take place. For that, since these three spheres are not in contact, first collision takes place between sphere 1 and 2. Let m be the mass, m dash, but of course m dash is equal to m, and u, u dash be the velocities before impact, and u, u dash are the velocities, and v, v dash are the velocities after impact. After impact, I take this as A, B, C. We can refer the spheres also by A, B, C, or first, second and third. Now, to begin with, since the first sphere moves towards the other two and they are on a straight line, first collision takes place, first impact is between first and two, first and second. Now, by conservation of momentum, so in this topic we use only three fundamentals of impact: conservation of momentum, Newton's experimental law, and one more thing is there is no friction, they are smooth. What is conservation of momentum says? Mv plus m dash v dash is equal to mu plus m dash u dash. Therefore, say, what is v dash? V dash is, we have taken v dash, v dash are velocities after impact, u dash are velocities before impact, and m dash are the masses, or of course m dash is same as m. Therefore, mv dash is equal to mu, because this is 0, u dash is 0, u dash is 0. Therefore, v plus v dash is u. Take this as 1. V plus v dash is u. Second, by Newton's experimental law, v dash minus or v minus v dash is minus e into u minus u dash. It is Newton's experimental law. What is e? E is given as half here. Therefore, v minus v dash is minus half into u minus 0. V minus v dash is minus half u. This is 2. V minus v dash is minus half u. Now, from 1 and 2, you have to find out v and v dash. From 1 and 2, adding, what you get? V is equal to 1 by 4 u. V is equal to 1 by 4 u. Add in. And v dash is v plus 1 by 2 u. So 1 by 4 u plus 1 by 2 u. So it is 3 by 4 u. See, this is important. What is the velocity of the sphere after impact is important. That gives the idea about the collision, next collision. V is 1 by 4 u, V dash is 3 by 4 u. What does implies? This implies V is 1 by 4 u and V dash is 3 by 4 u. Therefore, V dash moves faster than, second sphere moves faster than the first one after the impact. So, in the first impact, this is the result. Velocity of second sphere is greater than first sphere. Therefore, second sphere moves faster than this one and collision takes place between second and third. Now, the collision takes place between second and third and we have to find out now. Second collision or second impact is between second and third. Now, V dash is, now we take capital V, V dash. Can you make the difference between these two? This is small V, this is capital V. Now, capital V and V dash be their velocities. After impact. Capital V is the velocity of this, V dash is velocity of third sphere after impact. That means after second impact. Now what are the masses? Same, M. Now U, U dash be the velocities before impact. Again I take U, U dash is the velocities before impact. For second collision, U, U dash. What is U? U is 3 by 4 U, U dash is 0. U is 3 by 4 U means, I only notation here, initial velocity of second sphere, that is these two are impacting, these two collide now. What is initial velocity of this? 3 by 4 U. What is initial velocity of this? 0. What is E? Half. It remains same. Therefore, again by conservation of momentum, m dash u dash is equal to, or I directly take m into capital V, m dash into capital V dash is equal to mu plus m dash u dash. M into capital V plus m into V dash is equal to m into, what is small u? 3 by 4 u plus 0 it is. Therefore, capital V plus V dash is equal to 3 by 4 u. I take this as 3. 3 by 4 u. Now use Newton's experimental law. By Newton's experimental law, what does law says? V minus V dash is minus 1 by 2 into U minus U dash. V minus V dash is minus 1 by 2. What is U? U means initial velocity of the second sphere. It is 3 by 4 U and it is 0. So minus 3 by 8 U. V minus V dash is minus 3 by 8 U. This is 4. This is the second impact. V plus V dash is, V minus V dash is this. Solve this. What do you get? 2V is equal to 3 by 4 minus 3 by 8. 3 by 4. Adding 3 by 4 minus 3 by 8. So, it is 3 by 8 U. So, what is V? 3 by 16 U. This is important. 3 by 16 U. And similarly, V dash is 9 by 16 U. 9 by 16 U. Now, what is V? Small V. This is velocity of the first sphere. See, after the second impact, we have to consider this also. Because first one also moving in the same direction. But it is lagging behind. Now, we have to observe what happens after second impact. Now, after second impact, see, these are the velocity of the spheres. What is the velocity of first sphere? velocity of first sphere is 1 by 4 u, second is 3 by 16, third is 9 by 16. This is first one, second one, third one. Now, here 3 by 4 means it is 12 by 16 it is, multiply by 4, 12 by 16, 3 by 16, 9 by 16. Now see the speeds now, after second impact, this 1 by 4 it is, this is 1 by 4, V is 1 by 4, U, capital, this is velocity of first sphere, second, third. Now at this moment, after second impact, 1 by 4 U, 3 by 16 U, 9 by 16 U, 1 by 4 means 4 by 16. Now therefore, say velocity 9 by 16 is greater than 3 by 16, but this 4 by 16 is greater than 3 by 16. So what's your conclusion? Now the speeds are like this. Second sphere, now I take second sphere, first sphere, third sphere. What is the third sphere velocity now? Present velocity 9 by 16. What is the velocity of this? 3 by 16. What is the velocity of this? 3 by 4, sorry, 1 by 4 or 4 by 16. Therefore, see here, this is, this now on, they are on the straight line. Velocity of this third sphere is greater than second. But since this is also moving, first sphere is also moving, but its velocity is greater than second one. Now, third collision takes place between these two. Followed, third collision takes place between these two. Now the speeds are 4 by 16, 3 by 16, 9 by 16 are the speeds of the three spheres. Therefore now since this first sphere moves faster than the second one, third collision takes place between first and second again. Third collision or third impact is between first and second. Suppose w dash b velocity is after impact and u dash b velocity is before impact. So by conservation of momentum, what does law of momentum says? Mv plus mv dash is mu plus mu dash. Now carefully substitute. M into w plus m into w dash is m into u. What is u? 4 by 16. Plus m into u dash. What is u? 3 by 16. Correct? 4 by 16. 3 by 16 u. Yes. Therefore, w plus w dash is 4 by 16, 3 by 16. 7 by 16 u. Take this as 5. This is 5. And also, by Newton's experimental law, w minus w dash is minus half, because e is minus half, into u minus u dash. What is that? 1 4 by 16 u minus 3 by 16 u. How this is applied? W minus v minus v dash is minus or v minus v dash is minus e into u minus u dash. But u is 4 by 16 now for this. U dash 3 by 16. Therefore w minus w dash is simplify this. What do you get? W minus W dash is, it is, how do you simplify, 4 minus 3, 1 by 16, minus 1 by 32 U, this is 6, am I correct? Minus 1 by 32 U. Now you have to solve 5 and 6, this 5 and 6, solve 5 and 6, W is equal to solving 5 and 6, 13 by 64 u. Am I correct? W is 7 by 16 minus. So 14 minus 1. Yes. 13 by 32. 13 by 64 u. And what is W dash? Now from we are solving 5 and 6. W is 13 by 64 and W dash is 15 by 64 u. 15 by 64 u. Now these are the now velocities after second impact of the spheres. What is this? This is second W, this is first, this is second, and one more we have to consider. Third sphere is also, it is also moving. Continuously it is moving on the same straight line on the table. What is the speed of this in which it is which speed it is moving? 9 by 16 u. Now this is the speed of the three spheres. Speed of first sphere, second sphere, third sphere. So after third impact, we have to find out the speeds now. Or we have to verify the speeds in which they are moving. Third sphere is 9 by 16, therefore it is 36 by 64. I make this LCM common, denominator common. Second sphere is 15 by 64. First sphere is 13 by 64 u. I think this is clear now. After third collision, third impact, the ultimate speeds of the three spheres are, first sphere is 13 by 64 u, second sphere is 15 by 64, third sphere is 36 by 64. Now see here, it is in the increasing order. What is this? Speed is 36 by 64, this is 15 by 64, 13 by 64. Now therefore they are kind of moving continuously on the table with this velocities. Therefore there is no collision, because so third sphere moves with greater velocity than second one, and this is greater than first one. So only three impact were there and no further collision will take place, and ultimate speeds of the final speeds of these spheres are 13:15:36. I think solution all have followed. This one was a fine example where only problem is simple. What is that? You have to apply only conservation of momentum and Newton's experimental law. But ultimate speeds you have to find out. Which collision, first collision takes place between two spheres, which two spheres, and second among which of the two spheres, and so on. I think the solution is clear. Next problem is, I take one more problem here. A ball impinges directly upon another ball at rest. Take this. A ball impinges directly upon another ball at rest and is itself reduced to rest by impact. If half of the initial kinetic energy is destroyed in the collision, find the coefficient of restitution. What is the problem? A ball impinges directly on another ball at rest. Second ball was at rest. This is first. Second, m dash be the masses. M dash be the masses. Equal, whether it is going, no, not equal. A ball impinges directly upon another ball at rest and itself reduced to rest by impact. If half of the kinetic energy is destroyed in the collision, find the coefficient of restitution. Suppose direct collision it is AB, MM dash, UU dash with the velocities before impact, VB dash with the velocities after impact. Now, what you have to find out? Find the coefficient of restitution. Now, what is given here? U dash is 0. Given, U dash is 0 because second sphere was at rest. And V is equal to 0 because V is velocity after impact of first sphere. After impact, the first sphere come to rest. Therefore, V is 0, U dash is 0. Now, first we apply Newton's experimental law. By Newton's experimental law, V minus V dash is minus E into U minus U dash. Therefore, 0 minus V dash is minus E into U minus 0. So, V dash is E into U. This is 1. V dash is E into U. Second, by conservation of momentum, law of conservation of momentum, what we are going to find out here? E we have to find out. And I think all of you understood what is given. E we have to find out. By Newton's experimental law, we have V dash is equal to EU. And conservation of momentum, what does conservation of momentum says? MV plus M dash V dash is MU plus M dash U dash. Total momenta before impact is same as total momenta after impact. So, M into 0 it is. M dash V dash is equal to MU and U dash is 0. Correct? Therefore, V dash is equal to U. No, M, they are different. M dash is M into U. This is 2. M dash V dash is M into U. Correct? M dash V dash is M into U. This is 2. One more thing is given here. What is that? What is given? Loss of kinetic energy is half of the kinetic energy. Half of the initial kinetic energy. So this is the third one we have to use here. Half of loss of kinetic energy is half of the initial kinetic energy. This is given. Therefore, initial kinetic energy, or we take like this. What is meant by loss of kinetic energy? Total kinetic energy after impact minus total kinetic energy before impact. Therefore, final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy is equal to, what is this? Half of the initial kinetic energy is lost. So, minus half initial kinetic energy. See here, why I have taken minus here? Because it is lost. Energy is lost. Minus half of initial kinetic energy. Therefore, final kinetic energy is half of initial kinetic energy. Verify. Final kinetic energy is half of initial kinetic energy. Final kinetic energy, what is that? Half into m dash v dash square is equal to half initial kinetic energy. Half mu square. What is kinetic energy? Half into m dash v dash square plus m dash half mv square plus m dash v dash square. But v is 0 here, see. Therefore, we have only half m dash v dash square. And initial kinetic energy is half mu square plus half m dash u dash square. But u dash is 0, so we have only this. So, m dash v dash square is half into mu square. Now, this is 3. From 1, 2, 3, you have to find out E. From 1, 2, 3, find out E. For that, 1 by 2 mu square. Right? Therefore, m dash v dash square is, what is v dash? M dash v dash is mu. Or m dash v dash square. What is v dash from first one? Refer first one. V dash is eu. Therefore, I take m dash eu square is half m into, correct? Half m into, what is u? Or v dash we have to eliminate. Yes, v dash is expressed in terms of this. Half mu square. Therefore, e square m dash u square is equal to half mu square. U square cancels. Now, what is m dash? Finally, if you substitute m dash, you get e. We have e square m dash is half into m. Half into m. Which one we have to use now? E square m dash is half into m. Now we have to eliminate m dash and m. Which relation we have to use? M dash, three relations we have. First, just a minute. M dash v dash square is, correct? M dash v dash square is half mu square. Half mu square. So half mu square is, half mu square is m dash e square u square. U square cancels. Correct? U square cancels. What is m? This is 2. What is 1? 1 is v dash is equal to e into u. V dash is e into u. First one. Just a minute, from this step, half m dash v dash square is, m dash v dash square is half into mu square, correct? Half into mu square. Therefore, half mu square is, what is m dash? Half mu square is m dash, this is m dash. I substitute here m dash. What is v dash square? V dash square is e square u square. Correct? U square cancels. So half m is m dash e square. M dash e square. But what is half m is, whether it is possible to use this one? M dash. This is 2, this is 1. We have to use only 1 and 2. M dash is, yes, half m is, what is m dash from this? M dash is mu upon v dash. Mu upon v dash into e square. Correct? This m cancels. Half is, what is u? For v dash I substitute here, u, e u, e square. Just simplification here. This u cancels now. E is therefore half. E is half. I have struggled little bit here. I have struggled little bit here. Only elimination here. Finally, I got this. That is fine. E is half. Value of E is half. Now I continue next problems, that is oblique impact, in the next video. Okay, thank you.